Yes, so here as usual that you are seeing the topic that gradient and intercept beta. Gradient and intercept, gradient you have to understand in this way. Suppose that what your inclination that line or line is creating with respect to either x-axis or y-axis. Okay, that is your gradient. Gradient is also known as slope. Okay, or inclination. Okay, so and also you can understand that gradient is defined as projection of y to x. Okay, projection of y to x. So let's see that what type of things that are given here. Let's start. Yeah, here you can see that the gradient of a line is a number representing its slope. Okay, also you can see on your screen there is a graph. So here you can see clearly that this line that is with respect to x-axis. So in that condition it is not representing any type of angle with respect to x or y-axis. So that means its gradient that will be zero. Understand?
Yes.
Good. And nextly, suppose that you can see this line. So this line you can clearly understand that here the blue line that is passing through the origin. Okay, and also it's a gradient that is equals to 1. Now I'm going to tell you that how it's a gradient that will be equals to 1. Give me one second. I'm taking my graphing tablet and I'm going to on that. Give me one second. Yeah, wait a second. Do you understand that? What is gradient, beta?
Yes, sir.
Okay, that's good. Yeah, as usual, whatever that you will not be able to understand, I'll explain that 100 times. Yeah, doesn't matter all that. Just see that on your screen, beta. Pardon?
Nothing, sir.
Oh, yes. So, beta, as I am explaining that gradient, that is defined as projection of y to x, that is y over x, that will be, that means how much, means any point that you can take over here, like this, okay? This point that you are taking here, okay? So that means you are moving 3 units to y, okay? 3 units to y, like this, okay? And that means it will be your 3. And also, you are moving 3 units with respect to x, okay? So that means it will be 3. So that's why that you can clearly understand that you can simplify that 3 ones are, that means now you will get there 1. Now you understand that how gradient is coming 1?
Yes, sir.
Fantastic.
That's great. Bye-bye.
Yes. So in this way we can assign that if your graph is given on if your line that is given on graph and you have to find the slope of that. So regarding to that one, you have to understand that gradient formula, that is projection of y.
Yeah, gradient formula we have.
Yes, that is 3 by 3, that is equals to 3 ones are 3, and then you will get 1 as your gradient. Do you understand that?
Yes, I understand.
Good.
So, we have formula to find the gradient.
Yes, yes. So, there is also formula, beta. There is also formula. I would like to tell you the formula also. So, that this one was this one. Yes. Suppose that here you are seeing a purple line over here. Okay. This one you are seeing a purple line. They are saying that the gradient of this almost vertical to line is 10. Okay. That is your 10. So that means 5 that will be with positive of y-axis and 5 with respect to negative of y-axis.
Okay.
So they are opposite to each other. So 5 minus minus 5 that will be equals to 5 plus 5 that is 10. Clear? Yes. So as usual that a vertical line that has an infinite gradient. Okay. A vertical line, whatever yellow that you are seeing that with respect to y-axis, that has an infinite gradient. Understand? Okay. So, how are these numbers calculated? Yes, you can see clearly here. Upon a cross. Okay. Gradient, you can understand there. Upon a cross. Clear? So here you can see that your line is crossing this. Are you able to see this pink line on the graph?
Yeah.
Okay. So now clearly, beta, you can see that up upon a cross. You can see that from the origin point, you have to move 2 units up with respect to y, and 2 units here with respect to x.
Okay.
Up upon a cross, that is 2 by 2, that is equals to 1. Do you understand that?
Yes.
Good. Yes. So here, it doesn't matter where you draw the triangle, okay? It doesn't matter where you draw the triangle, only 2 points that you would like to take over there, and then you can draw your graph, okay?
Okay.
Yes. And always remember that your graph, regarding to your graph, you can get your slope by formula up upon a cross. Okay? Yes. The gradient of a line where y and x changes by the same amount, that will be equals to 1 always. Okay.
Okay.
That means if you are displacing, with respect to x and y axis, same unit, okay? That means suppose that the 4 units on x axis and 4 units on y axis, then always remember that your graph will be equals to 1 there.
Okay.
Clear?
Clear.
Good. Now, you can see here that here is your also a line there, and it's a graph. You can see that a line is passing with respect to y axis at 1. And also with respect to x, you can consider that it is 0.5, okay?
Okay. That's the
In this way that your graph will be equals to how much?
No, that's the off of 1, right? 0.5.
No, up is your 1, beta. You can see that here. Are you able to see my moving cursor?
Yes, sir.
Up is your 1 unit, beta. Up is your 1 unit. That's why that they are writing here 1. And across, that is across, that means with respect to x-axis. You can see that it is 0.5. So you are writing 0.5 here. Okay. Then 1 upon 0.5, you have to simplify.
2.
So that will be equals to 2. Fantastic. And then that will be here. That's great. Do you understand it?
Yes, I understand.
That's great. Now, come to the next one. Look at these two diagrams. Okay. These are of different type of graphs, beta. Okay. And in the first one, you can see that you are coming downwards, okay? You are coming downwards, okay? Then, from both of them, fundamental rule is that up upon a cross, that is 2 by 3. Up, that is 2. And across, that is 3. Okay? But most important thing that in your first, that is left-hand side graph, you are coming downwards, okay? You are coming downwards. So in that condition, okay, so you can see here, you are coming downwards. Yes, downwards. Okay, so that means y is decreasing and x is increasing, beta. Okay, you are coming downwards. You are coming downwards. That means y is decreasing and x is increasing. So in this way, and here on the other graph, you can see that y x is decreasing and y is increasing. Okay. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Then always remember that downhill slopes will be negative. Okay. Downhill slopes, that means if you are coming up to down, then that is known as your downhill hill, downhill slope. And if you are moving down to up, then that is your means uphill. Okay. So in that way, beta, if you are getting downwards, so how much you are getting down? You can understand in this way, beta. Just see on your screen. You are miss up upon gradient. Wait, gradient. Gradient
across
equals to miss up upon across. across. That is your formula, okay? But you can see here. Up, up, that means you are coming downwards, okay? So here will be beta minus 2. You are moving downwards, okay? Upon, across that you are moving 3. That's why your gradient, that will be minus 2 by 3, okay?
Okay.
And also you can understand that it is your downhill, okay? Yes, it is your downhill graph. Clear, bete?
Yes, sir.
Good. Now, you can see...
Sir, but opposite one, it's like plus 2, right?
Yes, sir, bete. Yes, yes. Yes, you can see that you are coming downwards. You are coming downwards. So, if you are coming downwards, then the value of y, that is decreasing and the x is increasing. Okay. So, that's why that it is your downhill graph, and that's why that you can see that it is your negative. Okay. Now you can see the next graph. Next graph with respect to next color that I can do here. So gradient, beta, gradient. Again, that formula is up upon across. Across. That means up you are moving 2 units upward, okay? Upward, okay?
Okay.
So you can write here 2 upon. And also you are moving that 3 units across. Yes, that is 3. In that condition, your gradient will be 2 by 3. And it is your positive, okay? Positive gradient.
Okay.
Do you understand that?
Yes, sir, got it.
Very good. Now, I'm refreshing that beta so that next type of that we would like to see there. It was in second section. Yes, this one I explained. I think I explained that to you. So now we can move to the third one. Also, just see here. Okay. Do you understand what I explained that to you?
Yes, sir.
Okay.